Good morning, students. In last class, we have discussed what is a polynomial, right? And based on that, we have discussed the classification of polynomials. We had done classification of polynomials on the basis of number of terms and the basis of degree, okay? And we also saw what is the degree of the polynomial, right? What is a constant polynomial? What is a zero polynomial? In today's class, based on that, we are going to solve exercise 4.1. Say exercise 4.1. Say the first question. Which of the following expressions are polynomial in one variable? And which are not? State reasons for your answer. So first one, 4x square minus 3x plus 7. Now see a student, in exercise 4.1, the first main tells us that which of the following expressions are polynomial in one variable, which are not, a state reason for your answer. You have to tell whether this is a polynomial in one variable or no. Now see here the first question, 4x square minus 3x plus 7. Yes, this is a polynomial. What is the polynomial definition? An algebraic expression in which the variable should have the non-integral power. Yes or no? In short, what I will tell? An algebraic expression in which the variable should have the power should be a whole number. Yes or no? Now see. Now see the powers here. Here this is a polynomial in one variable. Yes, is there? This is one variable. To tell this is polynomial, see the powers. Here x power is 2, here x power is 1. This is a whole number, right? Therefore, what we can tell? Yes. Yes, this is polynomial in one variable. Okay. Now we will see second one, y square plus root 2. Now see, y square plus root 2 is a polynomial. Yes, because here the power of y is, the variable power is 2. Here 2 is a whole number. Yes or no? Therefore, what we can tell? Solution. Yes. This is a polynomial in one variable. Say third one, 3 square root of t plus t square root of 2. Now see a student, is this is a polynomial? Check it, is this is a polynomial in one variable? See a variable is t, one variable is there, but this is nothing but 3 t raised to 1 by 2 plus t square root of 2. Now see, the power of the variable is 1 by 2. Is 1 by 2, is half is a whole number? No. Therefore, what we can tell, this is not a polynomial in one variable. This is not a polynomial because here the variable power, here the variable power is not a whole number. Yes, therefore this is not a polynomial. So what we can write here is solution no it can be observed that the power of the variable, power of variable t in term 3 root of t is 1 by 2, which is not a whole number. Which is not a whole number. Therefore, this expression is not a polynomial. Expression is not a polynomial. Yes or no? See, here the power of t is, or the exponent of t is 1 by 2. Here 1 by 2 is not a whole number. Therefore, this is not a polynomial. Now see fourth one. Y plus 2 by y. Now see a student, this is nothing but y plus 2. 1 by y is nothing but what? Y raised to minus 1. Yes or no? 1 by y is nothing but y raised to minus 1. Now see a student, is this is a polynomial? No, this is not a polynomial because the here the power of the variable is a negative number, that is minus 1. What I told the definition? An algebraic expression in which the variable's power should be a non-negative integral. Yes or no? Here, the power of the variable should be a whole number. Yes? No, but here, minus 1 is there. Minus 1 is a negative number. Therefore, this is not a polynomial. Because here, the variable, power of the variable is not a whole number. What we can tell here? Solution. No. It can be observed, it can be observed that the power of variable y in turn 2 by y is 2 multiplied by y raised to minus 1, which is not a is minus 1, which is not a whole number. Why I am writing this? Because they told to write the reason, state reason for your answer. We have to write the reason for this. Therefore, this expression is not a polynomial. okay, because the variable power is -1. -1 is not a whole number. Now we will see one more. They have given fifth one. Fifth one's here. X raised to 10 plus Y raised to 3 plus T raised to 50. Now see a student, is this is a polynomial in one variable? They are asked here whether this is a polynomial in one variable. They are not asked just is this is a polynomial. They are asked is this is a polynomial in one variable? No, because here three variables are there. This is a polynomial in three variables because here three variables are there, that is X, Y and T. Okay, what our answer? Solution. This is no. It can be observed that this expression is a polynomial in three variables. That is X, Y and T. Therefore, this is not a polynomial in one variable. Okay, it's a simple concept. What is a polynomial? If you know the definition of polynomial, definitely you can easy to solve, right? What is a polynomial? Simple, an algebraic expression in which the variable involved should have the power should be a whole number. Okay, whatever in algebraic expression the variable involved, no, their power should be, it should be a whole number. Now we will see the second main of this exercise. So second main, write the coefficients of x square in each of the following. First one, 2 plus x square plus x. Second one, 2 minus x square plus x cube. Third one, pi by 2 x square plus x. Fourth one, root 2 x minus 1. Now see a student, write the coefficient of x square in each of the following. We have to write the coefficient of x square here. Solution. Tell me student, in first one, what is the coefficient of x square? What is the coefficient of x square here? It is nothing but 1. The first answer is 1. Second one, you see, what is the coefficient of x square here? It is minus 1. Third one, see student, what is the coefficient of x square here? It is pi by 2. Fourth one, you see, what is the coefficient of this? Now see a student, fourth one, square root of 2 multiplied by x minus 1. This can be written as 0 dot x square plus root 2 x minus 1. Is it not correct? Yes, yes, 0 multiplied by anything is 0 only, yes. 0 multiplied by anything is 0 only. Again, this equation only come, no? Sorry, this expression only will come, no? This is an expression, not an equation, right? See, if I write like this, is there any problem? No. Now tell me, what is the coefficient of x square here? It is 0. Okay, this is about the second main. Now we will go for the third main. See, now they are asked, give an example each of a binomial of degree 35 and a monomial of degree 100. Now see, students, give an example each of a binomial of degree 35. What is the meaning of binomial? A polynomial which is containing two terms is nothing but a binomial. They told to give an example for binomial of degree 35. See, a binomial of degree 35, you have to give an example. You can write 3x raised to 35 plus 5. Is this is not a binomial? See, and a polynomial containing two terms is nothing but a binomial. What they gave condition? You have to write one binomial. That degree should be 35. Here degree of this x is 35, right? Okay. Next, here they told to write example. Monomial of degree 100. Okay, 4x raised to 100. Is this not a monomial of degree 100? Yes or no? See, and polynomial containing one term. This is one term. A polynomial containing one term is nothing but a monomial, but they are given condition, you have to write one example for monomial in such a way that the degree should be 100. So this is about third main. You can give different examples also. Next we will see the fourth main. So write the degree of each of the following polynomials first one 5 multiplied by x raised to x cube plus 4x square plus 7x. Second one, 4 minus y square. Third one, 5t minus root 7. Fourth one, 3. Now, what they told, write the degree of each of the following polynomial. What is the degree of the polynomial? The highest power of the variable, right? The highest power of the variable is nothing but the degree of the polynomial. Here word is very, very important. Highest, the highest power of the variable is nothing but the degree of the polynomial. Now see a solution. Now see, first one, in this polynomial, what is the highest degree? Here the highest degree is 3. Means here 3 is the degree of this polynomial. What we can write? The highest degree of the the highest degree of the polynomial, that is 5x cube plus 4x square plus 7x is, what is the highest degree of this? It is 3. Therefore, degree of 5x cube plus 4x square plus 7x is 3. Okay. Now say second one, 4 minus y squared. Say what is the highest degree of this polynomial? Here it is 2 only, right? What we can write? The highest degree of polynomial 4 minus y square is 2. Therefore, degree of 4 minus y square is 2. Okay. Similarly, third one you see, 5t minus root 7. Now see here, what is the degree of this polynomial? The degree of this polynomial is, what is the highest degree? Here it is 1 only, right? What we can write here? The highest degree of polynomial, that is 5t minus square root of 7 is 1. Therefore, degree of 5t minus square root of 7 is 1. Okay. In the similar way, we will see the solution of fourth one, 3. Now, see, student, I told you that which polynomial is this? Just recap. This is constant polynomial. Yes or no? What is a constant polynomial? A polynomial which is containing only one term, consisting of a constant term. Right? 3 is a constant term. Yes or no? What is the degree of this? The degree of the constant polynomial is what? 0. What we can write here? So degree of 3 is 0. Okay? Degree of 3 is 0. Or you can write degree of polynomial 3 is 0. Okay? This is about the degree of the polynomial. Now we will see the fifth mean. So fifth one, see, classify the following as linear, quadratic and cubic polynomials. So first one, x square plus x. Second one, x minus x cube. Third one, y plus y square plus 4. Fourth one, 1 plus x. Fifth one, 3t. And sixth is r square. And 7th is 7x cube. Now see here students, classify the following as a linear, quadratic and cubic polynomial. I told you that a polynomial in which the degree is 1, that is called, if the degree of the polynomial is 1, that is called linear polynomial. If the degree of the polynomial is 2, it is called quadratic polynomial. If the degree of the polynomial is 3, that is called cubic polynomial. Now we have to tell here which is a linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomial. See a solution. You only tell me one by one, just answer it. What about this one? X square plus x, what it is? The degree of the polynomial is what? 2. Means this is a x square plus x is which polynomial? It is quadratic polynomial. Okay, what about second one? X minus x cube. What is the degree of this polynomial? 3. 3 means which polynomial this is? Is cubic polynomial. What about third one? 1 plus x. Which polynomial this is? Here, the degree of this polynomial is 1. 1 means it is a linear polynomial. Say fourth one. 1 plus x. What about 1 plus x? What is the So here I have done, it was fourth one, okay. This was fourth one. See third one. Y plus y square plus 4. Say what is the degree of this polynomial? It is 2. 2 means it is a quadratic polynomial. Is quadratic polynomial. Okay. Now fifth one. Fifth one is which polynomial student? Say the degree first. If you come to know degree, definitely you will get the answer. Fifth one, 3t. So what is the degree of this polynomial? It is 1. 1 means is linear polynomial. Next sixth one, r square, which polynomial this is? The degree of this polynomial is 2, means this is quadratic polynomial. Seventh one, 7x cube. See here, the degree of the polynomial is 3, means this is cubic polynomial. Okay, this completes your exercise 4.1. Okay, we will continue next class. Thank you.